Welcome to another Hearthstone video, and this is something I don't really do that often anymore, but this is kind of a special occasion, so yeah, here goes nothing. So the reason I'm making this video is that I recently built a new deck and it proved to be quite successful in Wild. Got up to rank 10, which I don't even go for other times. Mostly I'm just going for rank 15 just for the monthly award because, well, kinda have to get something out of it to stay in the loop and yeah, hopefully get somewhere at some point. But rank 10, that was the first and it ended up being quite easy with the deck. Afterwards I even got an email from Blizzard stating that I managed to get a 16 game win streak, which is kind of insane to be honest. So let's take a look at the deck. I usually only build my own stuff and there is no exception here, so yeah, while I've seen the basic premise of this somewhere, either from some opponent or in a YouTube video or so, I went ahead and did my own thing with it. So Egg Red Lantern means that it is a death rattle focused deck with some eggs in it. Namely the Nerubian Egg and the Devilsaur Egg. The Devilsaur Egg being kind of a new version of the Nerubian with kind of some bigger numbers. Instead of a 4-4, you summon a 5-5, but the egg has also one health more, which isn't necessarily a good thing, but it also costs one mana more. So just for redundancy's sake, so that I can draw it more often, I've got the Nerubian Egg as well, which should make this a lot more reliable. So to trigger some death rattles, we've got Playdead, we've got Feindeath, we've got the Terror Scale Stalker, and to some degree Spirit Singer Umbra, although she is more like, yeah, you gotta combo it, or you gotta combo her with something you can play on the same turn, otherwise she will likely be dead before you can play anything big next turn. So not always that useful, but in the later stages of the game she can proof to trigger anything I got in the lineup here. So other than that, we've got Explosive Sheep, which is a decent way to get rid of anything at least get rid of a lot of things that the opponent can come up with. The way this works is if you trigger this with Playdead or Feindeath or even the Terror Scale Stalker, that's more like a last yeah, the last thing you should do, because this will trigger twice in that case. First up, you trigger it with a Rattle Cry or the spell in that case, which means everything gets damaged by 2, also the sheep itself, which will blow it up and deal another 2 damage. So we've got like 2 ways, which not only looks nice, but it also can trigger some of the eggs or maybe, yeah, remove a lot of things from the opponent's side of the board. So if you put down some eggs beforehand and then just lay down the fire, it ends up really being a quite a nice board clear. So Explosive Trap, just to get rid of some aggro, also quite nice in some cases against Ice Block or something like that. It's done me a few good things over the course of games that I played, so definitely recommend that thing. We've got Feindeath, we've got Lavezooka, and for the eggs I should also mention that they become a lot more interesting. They become a lot stronger if you manage to give them some attack value so that they can just be thrown into an enemy and trigger that way, instead of having to wait for them to get rid of the eggs by, yeah, putting down some AoE or something. So Glaivezooka, one way to give some attack value to the eggs. Then we've got King's Elec as a draw engine and early game aggro tool, because 2 mana 3/2 isn't that bad. Can deal with a lot of 1/3 minions that have been introduced. So that's quite cool. Also, yeah, just to have some early game board presence before we lay down the pain with those things. The Loot Hoarder, Yeah. Getting some draw in Hunter is quite important, especially with a deck like this. It is a bit reliant on combos, so quite like that for that. For Lone Stalker, again, as I mentioned, giving them attack is quite strong. That's the thing I want with the most, but just giving a huge hand of yours some buffs is also quite okay. Shaky Zip Gunner, again, same theme with the X, buffing them is quite a nice thing. Also, I really like the like this minion in general, especially if, later on if you can eat it with a cube, that's also quite nice because overall this is 3 mana 5/5, even though the last two two are a bit slower than the first 3/3 part of a card. But if you do that, do some rounds of Death Rattle triggering with Feign Death also, you can suddenly get some really big minions in your hand. Terror Stalker just have more Death Rattle triggers. Barnes just to pull out some things like the X, for example. Them spawning as one once is quite nice because you can easily get rid of them and still spawn the full-sized minion out of it. The cube I already mentioned. To be honest, this thing is insane in two ways. If you really get a good egg trigger in the early game, that's insane tempo. And late game, if you get something out of this, it's also insane. So yeah, Sludge Burn just because it's a good turret minion. And also something that I would like to see eaten by the cube. Kernblood Hoof, kind of the same, just a very decent minion. Deathstalker Vexxar, that's not the best card in this deck, I feel. Sometimes some of the minions you can create can save you, but most of the time, at least the Battle Cry and the 5 armor can get you out of some sticky situations. So when the high main only had space to fit one, although this has also already got a decent top end. And Sylvanas Windrunner, because she is just a very good minion. So let's see at least, hopefully, one decent matchup here. Been going down a bit recently again, so I used to be at 16 already, but it's a bit of up and down. Not quite as straightforward of a win streak as last time, but it's earlier in the season. And still, I'm getting overall positive result with this deck.
Vexxar versus Magni.
So let's see, we got an egg, that's already
Again.
good. It's very good. I think we need Umbra. Umbra is more of a late game combo piece in the end, because she won't survive the turn after she's summoned. Oh, that's quite nice now. I don't necessarily want to use Feign Death on just one minion.
Are
I
you
mean, I
my
could definitely
master
do
now?
that.
That was a mistake.
But I can also just do this now.
Alone.
And as you can see, Lezuka helped me remove that minion and also spawn my own one. So for the next turn, I don't want to use the explosive cheap unless I have to. Okay, I don't know what this deck is. It's definitely not one of the ordinary ones. The thing with sheep is I always want to keep them as a low health minion, because if they go above 2, they may give me some issues in order to properly destroy them to get the double Death Rattle trigger. While it wouldn't make a difference right now, I'm okay, maybe now with 4 minions.
Beasts betrayed
This might
me.
be worth it. Also to give him something to burn his weapon on. If he has Execute, I don't want to play Sylvanas into it. But since that weapon is now gone,
Recall.
I might as well. Ah, oh, Dead Man's Hand. This is quite nice. I play a similar deck, so. Oh, you don't even see it being shuffled. That's interesting. I should maybe hang on to this.
This no look safe.
Just in case. If this survives, I will eat it with. Okay, never mind. And now we've got one explosive chip that's a bit too big. A bit too big to destroy itself. Am I really concerned about Cthulhu? I think I should be the. And let's just put this off. The fact that he used Dead Man's Hand so early means that he has some. He should have something there in his hand. Maybe one of the champions or so. Ah, okay. So let's see if I do it. If I play Sylvanas right now into Feign Death, what do I get? I get a 2-2 buff. This thing will trigger once, damage everything, but doesn't destroy much. Should be worth it. I don't want to buy your beard. Let's just get rid of it. I did not want to have that land on that. And there go my minions. Yeah. Ah, cool, card warp. Oh, hi, main.
A worthy foe.
Four attacks, so this should.
A worthy foe.
Oh, it won't live through that, but at least, well. Yeah, kind of played into that. I don't encounter girl. Garrosh quite often. Let's see what I get next. At least some card draw. I guess that's something. Need more cards. Yeah, and this way you can at least exploit the card war engine. Okay, I guess. I get at least 4 more cards out of his action, which is quite nice. Even if it doesn't have me kill him. I think he's trying to fatigue me now, which may. He could have burned a card of mine if he went for it. So what else could I do? I have Umbra. Let's put it right in the middle here. It will likely die, but at least I tried. I should have maybe put it between the two loot hoarders, which would have been a better placement. Because when if he attacked a loot hoarder, he would have. Oh. Doesn't even do it. Okay, the egg is not the one to live. That's interesting. Okay, he has to do it that way, but worse, of course. Yeah. If I go for this, I could pick up something that I want to eat with a cure. The cube. If I don't pick up anything, that should be good. I should be doing it.
Astounding.
Astounding is what will come out of it. Yeah, I got enough attack to kill it outright. Before that, I'm not done yet. Let's see, I have a few more spaces here. He may have another another ball, I don't know. If he has, this wasn't that great, but it was worth trying. He's not getting through that wall anytime soon. Only problem is I may well advance. Yeah. He's dead next turn. Only problem with this is I'm running out of space on my side of the field. Can I borrow some of his?
I choose death.
Oh, come on. We don't see that kind of deck that often, so. I love going crazy with this stuff, I gotta say. It's a lot of fun. So, yeah, that was one of the matches. I'm going to just quickly go to another, see if I can get another decent combo. Six large bashers is quite decent already. Oh, we get X. Let's go for X. Yeah, no death rattle trigger. But that may come later. So should I coin out an egg? That is the question here. Just for feign death possibility on turn 3 then. Because that would be turn 3, 8, 8. No hate, mate. Let's go for card draw. The ruby and egg next turn, definitely. If I get a terror scale stalker, that's yeah, 7-7 on turn 3. Or more like a 3-3 and a 4-4. Which amounts to the same. But no overload. Ooh, play that. At least 4-4-4-1, that's at least something, I guess. I don't know how the mana curve is now and how much you can expect to get out of it, but I think that's decent. Ah, that's one of the deaths that I don't usually see. Thing is, how scared am I of him bouncing it back next turn? I think scared enough. Scared enough to just do that right now. Sometimes you gotta try to disrupt your opponent more than to get your own things going. It didn't quite hit the mark. That's one turn too late. Doesn't really matter. We'll see how this goes now. Hopefully we get another Deathrattle mini next run, maybe the Zip Gunner also, that would be great. Otherwise, the next time will be a bit of a weak one. Definitely playing Explosive Trap into this.
Such big teeth I have.
Yep. Unless you get another sheep, then I could go with that, but yeah, let's just do this. Screw his board. And this is exactly why I got Explosive Trap in this, and also Explosive Sheep, because they are great dealing with the shit. Come on. You know what kind of trap it is. It's always explosive.
Think.
Burn. I mean, yeah, he gets a 3-2 out of it, but who really cares? Next turn, probably Bloodtooth, because he has 6 stuff instead of 5. Unlike the others. And I always want to keep Sylvanas in my hand until I can combo her with one of the Death Rattle triggers, so turn 8 would be the correct one here. If I can afford to wait. That's a surprise. So we never ever want to have to play high main. At least with 2-2, so should be able to get rid of Acid Maw. I never want to eat their eggs with Carnivorous Cube. It's hard to trigger them afterwards. Oh, with 2 Feigned Deaths in my hand, it may be worth it in this case, but yeah, usually I'd rather eat a minion that poses a threat to the opponent and can be used later on. Yeah, since the high main kinda resembles 3 minions at once, my opponent may be in a bit of a an issue with getting rid of all of them. Let's see what he comes up with. Giving me more minions. I don't know if that's really a good idea for him. He'd need a lot of burst to make up for that. So what do I do now? I have to get rid of this, and since it doesn't kill itself when getting damaged, I need to put my Savannah Highman into it.
I have no time for games.
It may live. Let's see. Oh yeah, I forgot. That doesn't work that way. That thing still has to die. So yeah, I don't know if my opponent can kill me right now, if he has lethal on hand. That doesn't look like it. So let's see, we've got 4, 8, 12, 15, 17 damage. Not quite enough, so This has to go, this has to go. This time I'm making a little space on my side of the field.
Let none survive.
And at least I can take over the opponent's minion and use it for my ends.
Well played.
Well played.
Smart moves. I concede.
Easy. Every other time I didn't consider the effortless figure in the same order as you played the minions, so of course my board was full at the point where Sylvanas tried to pull someone over. Last match for this video. But yeah, this is how it can go. There are some decent ways to get back, but unfortunately I wasn't able to showcase the early game things you can do with this deck. Maybe it will change now. I don't seem to be lucky, unfortunately. Unless I get something out of a loot hauler. Or I just use Feign Death a bit, well, not that effectively. Okay, Warlock having a one mana demon is that's promising. It may not be that cancerous. I think I have a decent idea of how the next two my next two turns will be going. Devil Saw Egg next turn, afterwards Explosive Sheep into Feign Death. Yeah, let's do that way. Because that will spawn me a 5-1 Devil Saw and it's tempting to just use Explosive Trap here, but Explosive Trap is easier to set up overall. Although, he's kinda playing into it, I can't let him get away with it. Yeah, this is how I deal with aggro. One card, pretty much. I suppose if she would be overstepping it a bit because I... he knows what it is. Maybe a sheep wouldn't have been such a bad idea after all. No, I don't have any targets for my Q. But next turn I will have. I can just put it out for deterioration. Fear me. Or at least the sheep.
Unleash me.
I mean, good thing about it is that now Cairn can kill him. Or he could. Yeah.
For honor.
And so much about that. I don't like having it to do in that order because, yeah, no, it's just a 4-1. Still better than me being dead also. And that tells me that he's going to try to build this up damage-wise. Which means I should just do this. Only question is now, which button is more advantageous for me? Definitely this. And I think I want to keep it easy on the mana cost. It would also be a decent way to close out the game. And I think if I... Do I go for 1 and 3?
I have no time for games.
I go for 1 and 3. Oh, that's nasty. Oh. No, I'm not emoting this. I did not deserve this, but, well. Holy. So, let's see, I've got a 6-mana charger. That will kill this. 4, 8. That's fine.
No look save.
Missed it.
Weakling, let none survive.
Yeah, doesn't really matter that much. Unless it's a Rhino lock. Play something like this. Oh, he will fucking hate me. How nasty am I? Pretty nasty. So, yeah, let's get a new card. Some lifesteal. He may concede now. Because I don't know what he can do against this stuff. Even if he were to just see never this, he would still face. Yep, that's kind of suicide in an honorable way. But that 33% steal, that was. I think that was where I won the game and he evidently lost it. Again, I did not deserve it, but I got it anyway, so. Yeah, you gotta have some luck every now and then, and that's also a factor in this thing. So, yeah, thanks for watching. See you next time. I don't know if I will record any more of this, but. Wow. Yeah, at least I'm having fun with the stuff. That's the reason why I got so far onto the ladder, because, well, otherwise I wouldn't be playing it. So, thanks for watching, have fun, see you next time, bye bye.